mindset of other stuff. So that's what we're going to concentrate on now. But you can take the Sangaku Jimmy. Okay, Sangaku Jimmy, you can do it the same way. Get them in position first, figure out how you get into that position, and then do it from transition. Okay, so look at the end result first, and see how you can build it up. How can you take that into transition? Okay, haven't got time, unfortunately, to do any more than what I wanted to do today. But I just wanted to, there's a timeline there. You have to figure it out. Okay, what I want to do now is just introduce you to something else. That's actually quite cruel. Okay, that's the only way you're going to learn. And I think it's important you understand that. Alright, so what we're going to do is get in a position. So if you lie down on your side. Okay, so we're going to get into this position. Here, this position that we're in. Okay, he knows what I'm going to do, don't you? I know he knows what I'm going to do. Okay, so I want you into this position to start with. The reason why I'm putting him here is if he ever gets into this position in Shiai, he's got to figure out how to get out. As coaches, this is not what you want to be telling them. You have to, they've got to experience it themselves. They've got to figure out a way out by themselves. Okay, I think as coaches, you've got to give them the scenario and be strong enough and brave enough to say, what are you going to do about it? You know, how are you going to get out? Okay, so this is where we are. Okay, when I say Hajime, he's got to get out. He's got to do something. You have to apply it. Okay, Hajime. Okay, Mate there. Hajime. Mate, all of a sudden, is he changing what he's doing? Okay? What do you mean? Mate, is he picking it up now? This is what happens. So he ends in the Shiai, he ends up in that position. Will he be better prepared now? That's where you have to take your... That's where you've got to take the judoka. Okay, you've got to take them to that level. So he experiences the pain, he understands if he doesn't move what the pain's about. And you've given him the opportunity to sustain that long enough until he's strong enough to be able to do that himself. I didn't tell him to do it that way, he figured it out himself. I think as coaches, you have to present the opportunity, put a scenario in place so that you can work that, okay? So, once your partner's got out, or if he hasn't, he's tapped, set it up again, you say Hajime in your own little area, and get on with it. Do that five times, no change around. No mercy. If you mercy the guy, then it's false. He's going into denial. He thinks he's better than he is, and he'll fail. You have to hit it full on. He's expecting it, okay? So you've got to work together, tap, you know, tap out if it hurts, set him up again and go for it. Do that five times and then change over. Okay? Somebody then?